Scotland trained for the final time on their 2013 summer tour. One man missing from the session is Johnny Beattie. Johnny has a thigh strain and is 50-50 to take his place in the team. One man present today was Matt Scott. He's been a consistent performer on the tour and scored his first international try against the Azzurri earlier this year.
I'm really looking forward to it, actually. It's a chance for us to get the first win on tour, and we came close last week and, you know, we were all gutted that we didn't, so it's great to get a chance to immediately bounce back and gain a chance to get that first win.
Looking back on the game last week, what do you take from that game in terms of building confidence? What was good?
The defence was good. I thought the attitude of the boys was really good in terms of the, you know, intensity at the tackle area and the collisions and stuff. I thought that was definitely a massive step up from where we were against Samoa. And I think, you know, we need to build our team around defence, and that gives, you know, the backs especially a chance to attack if we're defending well. So that was definitely a positive we could take out. And also just the fact that, you know, we were written off massively and we were leading, you know, the box until, you know, 20 minutes to go. I mean, we were still in it even in the last couple of minutes. We were only 6 points behind. So I think that's a massive positive for us, especially with a team where guys have got limited number of caps. You know, there's a lot of new guys come in, and I thought it was a really heroic effort from everyone.
Al Strokosh has been a consistent player for the team on this tour.
Yeah.
But so have you, Matt. And the one thing that we have with you at 12 is somebody who breaks a line, and that's a great asset for a 12 to have. You do it consistently, so what accounts for that consistency?
I think a lot of it comes from the forwards and guys working hard at the breakdown and just getting quick ball for us. And I know myself defending, it's always hard when the ball's coming at the ruck at 100 miles an hour and you've not got time to set up, and that's when defences are kind of in disarray. So I think in the past we've maybe been slow to win ball, and it's been hard for us bats because we've got a full line coming against us. So especially against South Africa in the first half, you know, I was gaining yards just purely because we were getting ball quick and we were just kind of able to play off the cuff and, you know, make those breaks. So yeah, that's something that we obviously need to keep improving. Yeah.
Greig Laidlaw will captain the side tomorrow against Italy, and he knows it'll be a tough test.
Italy are very strong in their set piece. That's a big part of their game plan, where they like to impose their game on us. So we need to try and take that away from them, and especially in the first 20 minutes.
They'll be smarting Greig with the two losses. The same as Scotland. So what do you expect from them? Because they've made quite a few changes to their side.
Yeah, they have made changes, and I think that shows that the guys coming in, kind of a similar task, that their players coming in will be there to prove a point to their coaches and try and make an impression for them. So I think, you know, it'll be a good thing for them. Their players will be desperate to show what they can do. So, again, that's why the start of the match, I believe, is so important for us.
In terms of the team run, the captain's run, there's always a huddle, and I'm always kind of keen to know what you're saying. What's your message been today to the Scotland team ahead of the match tomorrow?
The message, it was pretty simple, to be honest. You know, I say we kind of set a standard last week of where we want to be, and I say it was kind of easy last week in a way, because we were playing South Africa in a packed stadium in their home country. To get up for that one, and they rip us off big time, and this is a different challenge, but I expect absolutely no difference, and we need to build our energy from within that circle of players we're standing in. So that was my message, because this week, you know, we're probably not going to be playing in front of a big crowd, so it's about the group of players that take the field to represent Scotland to the best of their ability and make sure we come off that pitch with a win.
And the captaincy role, I mean, it's a very, you know, it's a great honour to be the captain of your country, the national rugby team. How have you found that role, and what do you get out of it? What's the positives that you get out of it?
I'm hugely honoured, first and foremost. It's, growing up in a rugby town that I came from, you know, to be able to captain your country is the ultimate for me. So, you know, it's a great feeling, and, you know, what you get from it, I like to try and play every game the same and prepare myself that way and try and lead by example. I think that's the best way to go, and definitely I think with somebody like Al Strokosh as vice-captain, we're certainly striking a good balance, well, I hope,